Pike, it's all on this USB drive. All the evidence you need to nail Typhon for Gabe's death and plenty more.
All right. Bring it with you. I'll meet you in an hour.
Thanks. Talk soon.
Citizens of Haven Springs, we are live at the Spring Festival. One final reminder to head over to the Lathe Flower Cart and grab a rose before they're gone.
At Haven's inaugural Spring Festival, eligible women of good stock and birthing age would offer up roses in order to attract a mate. What can I say? History is weird. Thankfully, we've lost the mating stuff, but kept the roses. And if you do have a special someone in mind, a rose is a great way to say you care. And an even better way to say, hey look, a rose.
Sounds fun. Is giving away a rose something I'd do? Maybe. I can decide downstairs. For now, I'll grab the USB. It's very tempting to curl up with this all night instead of leaving my apartment. I'm thinking this will make an excellent after-festival snack. I think I'll stick with Minesweeper from now on. Looks like the festival is already in full swing. Happy Spring Festival, Gabe. I remember trying to pregame as a teenager and just going to sleep instead.
Traditionally, you give roses to your crush at the Spring Festival, so...
I've never had a girl give me flowers before.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you cared so much about traditional gender roles. I'll get back to my butter churning and doilies.
Shut up.
You first.
I would do anything to put the two of them back together. I've been meaning to tell Jed about the sink, but I'm afraid he'll try to teach me how to fix it myself. Don't worry. I'll come back to you. When did I become such a fucking monster? Whoa. What was that? I can still feel some of Charlotte's anger from before. I'm about ready to start my own list. Will you be my date to the festival, Shushu?
The world really doesn't deserve Thaynor.
Alwyn the Bard will ride again. The USB stick is on my desk. So is this thing just decoration, or am I supposed to use it? I've been playing more these past few weeks than the last few years. Man, the latest issue gets dark. I'm sure Ethan will be fine. I think I'll stick with Minesweeper from now on. Yeah, this one ornament will really bring my tree together. What are the chances your instruction manual is in here? Ah, string lights. The key to unlocking the Cozy Places subreddit. For now, I'll grab the USB stick. One day I'll organize the stuff in here. Today is not that day. Okay. Time to head downstairs.
Test. Check. 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 Holy shit! You own a skirt?
Hey, guys.
Happy first Spring Fest.
Thanks. I need to apologize to you guys. What happened in the apartment? Something really messed me up. These past few weeks, I thought I had a handle on my emotions. But after what happened with Charlotte, it's the same old story. I lose control, and I hurt the people I care about. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Fuck that. If anyone needs to apologize, it's me. Ever since we've met, you've been there for me. And then when you're the one struggling, I bail. Not cool. I'm really sorry.
If we're both sorry, does that just cancel everything out?
I think so. We're back to normal.
Not to spoil the moment, but Typhon blew up their own mine. Why?
I don't know yet. But we have all the evidence we need to nail them for Gabe's death. I got a hold of Pike. He'll be here soon. Once he sees what's on that stick, it's over for Typhon.
Hence the celebration. I think we've all earned the right to enjoy ourselves a little tonight.
The band's coming on soon. You'd better be front and center.
Nice. Who's playing?
Local band. You'll love them.
I have to run back to the trailer. Go be a normal person for a while.
Can't make any promises. Text me when it's ready. If I wanted to give away a rose, Steph and Ryan would definitely be on my list. Anyway, time to enjoy the festival. Steph did a really great job putting all that together. I guess the festival started a while ago. just dropped a block of alabaster on purpose because I wouldn't stop digging. Two-faced bitch.
This game is so demoralizing. Why do I do this to myself?
The red one was 234.
Maybe I can help them somehow.
Damn it.
1, 2, 3.
Another year, another prize gift card for yours truly to keep. I'm such a little devil.
Really? Come on, Jellybean Lady. That's not right.
Another year, another prize gift card.
She looks awfully smug for a jelly bean lady. This is impossible, right? Hey there.
Guess the exact number of jelly beans and win a prize. Only one guess per person.
The exact number? Is that how this game is supposed to work?
You can go right after this determined young man.
This game is so demoralizing.
I've never seen anyone so focused on a jelly bean jar.
Another year, another prize gift card for yours truly.
My bad.
Another year, another prize gift card for yours truly to keep. I'm such a little devil.
Should I not have worn cologne? Is that too tryhard? Maybe I didn't wear enough.
Or maybe it's the total lack of saying anything. Crap. Was I supposed to give him a hug? Does he think that I think it's not a date? Aw, they'll get the hang of this one day, or not. My bad. She looks awfully smug. My bad.
I love that the radio station broadcasts live from the park.
Right? It almost makes it feel
this
like a tiny Coachella.
Is
awesome.
Super tight.
Favorite time of the year, by far.
That kind of enthusiasm is infectious, especially for me.
Do you remember that
song? Kind of enthusiasm is infectious, especially for me. So this is that whole communal gathering thing everyone's always going on about. Riley is feeling sentimental tonight, but I haven't seen her around. Where is she?
It happened last year.
Yep.
I remember it clear as...
Hi.
Oh, hey. Nice to see you.
You're taking this jelly bean thing very seriously.
Yeah, because the prize is a $100 gift card. Chrissy's been all anxious ever since she got lost. So, I thought I could get her a bunch of treats. Which is really embarrassing, saying it out loud.
Not at all. That's sweet. Maybe I can help.
Oh, for real? Are you good at this? How many jelly beans do you think there are?
It's always more than you think it is. I'd say like 800 or so.
Huh. Yeah, could be.
Feels like something just changed in that lady by the jar. Maybe I should read her.
800's actually not bad. Hopefully they don't go lower.
Oh, I was close? Maybe I should say something. This is impossible, right? I'm on to you, Jellybean Lady.
This game is so demoralizing. Why do I do this to myself?
Maybe I can help him somehow. Hey, I've got another guess.
Yeah?
I think it's closer to 700.
Yeah, 700 feels right. But we have to get it exactly.
Just felt that lady's heart skip a beat. I should read her again.
Dear me, they're really close to 731. Who is this girl?
Hell yes! Your secret's mine. The answer is 731. Don't ask me how.
731 jelly beans.
That's correct.
Yes! Thanks so much for your help. You rule.
No sweat.
I can't believe it. How did she know?
Just a lifetime of emotional trauma.
Best spring fest ever.
And so, peace returned to the Jellybean Kingdom.
Probably. Probably around 10 or 11 p.m. And he was already drunk as a skunk. Boy.
I don't think this thing is checking IDs. Nobody tell Pike. Wow. This is a beautiful model.
But anyway, he comes
it's
racing
been a hell
out
of a month.
Diner.
But this
over a couple of tables
makes it all worthwhile.
Jed loves this town so much. It's inspiring.
I see him hauling ass toward the dock, and I get on after him because I know what.
Oh, hi, Val. They even looped you into participating, huh? That kind of enthusiasm is infectious, especially for me.
Okay, so there's this young farm maid in Elder's countryside.
Thanks for helping me find the bun again.
Sounds like Ethan wasn't the only one inspired by the LARP today.
Along the way, she picks up mercenaries, the kind she never expected.
I heard the call. And I wanted to thank you. I know you tried to do the right thing.
So, what now?
I'm taking Typhon down. The whole hornet's nest.
I'm not betting against you. But in the meantime, they're the only ones cutting checks in town. And I still got plenty of bills to pay.
Come on, Mac. Even you're too good to work for them.
It's always flattering to see how much you care about me. No wonder you try to break up me and Riley.
Ugh. There's the Mac I know. Sounds like Ryan is ready for me. I better head back.
So then, where's the after party this year?
After party?
God, come on.
I just hope Riley
Young
is
man
doing
like yourself.
Right.
You oh, must no. know what the haps is.
What happened to Riley?
Honestly.
Hi, Eleanor.
Good evening, dear.
Hey, so where's Riley? I haven't seen her around.
She's not really in the festive spirit. She was supposed to leave town tonight. If it wasn't for, you know.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You were so helpful to me that day at the shop. If you see Riley, maybe you could help her too.
Sure. I'll try my best. So, we doing shots tonight or what?
Of course. Body shots. Who's going first? Just kidding. Or am I?
Decorations really turned out beautifully. It must have been a huge amount of work.
It's worth it.
I better get going.
Enjoy your night.
You too. There's no graceful way to sample everything on this table.
Is there?
The world's most unnecessary vodka delivery system. There's no graceful way to sample everything on this table. Is there? Oh, Mr. Lantern, I love what you've done with your bar.
Took a minute, but I dragged his ass back to dry land and we called.
It's nice to see Jed so in his element.
So the
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Hey, thanks. Man, this show rules. It's something. Anyway, I'm Izzy. That's Steph. We're Drugstore Makeup from Seattle. We've got, merch. Dude, count me in. I'm dying.
Doing this takes a certain type of person, and I am not that person. Random ATV parked at a festival with a bunch of drunk people? What could go wrong?
something for you.
Alex. I wasn't mentally prepared for that at all. Wow. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Actually, I've got something for you too. Think we could meet up after the show?
Of course.
All right, well, this is pretty much set. Are you ready?
Yeah. Who's playing?
Yours truly.
Seriously? That's awesome! Well, wait, who else? Steph. Who else is playing? I hate you both.
We didn't want you to wuss out.
Who said anything about wussing out?
Nobody, but only because we didn't give you the opportunity.
This is gonna be awesome, trust me.
We've never played together before, and anyway, sorry if this sucks. Fuck it. Hey, Charlotte. How deep do you think? The lake, I mean. I don't know. I felt horrible this afternoon. I didn't know if I could survive that feeling. But now, it's like when your leg falls asleep. And even though it's still attached, it's become something other than you.
whole life, I've always felt so deeply. But maybe this is better?
Charlotte, I'm so sorry.
Sorry for what?
I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Me neither. Good to see you, Alex. Have fun at the festival.
Sounds like Ryan wants to meet me on the rooftop.
Okay, I gotta admit, this is a pretty great feeling. Neighbors? Come on.
What are you so happy about? Been a while since I've seen you smile like that.
It's that cake. That dragon-shaped
ice cream
cake. We're ice cream
geniuses.
I feel like
we run this shit.
Keep flexing, ice cream lady.
As soon as you thought of it.
I can't stop thinking about it. Could we do a castle-shaped cake box?
Yeah. Yeah, that's good. What if we did little swords instead of serving knives?
Oh my god.
Back to the party. But I should get to the roof. That's sweet, but I think I'll avoid touching this bench, just to be safe.
This is awesome! Favorite time of the year, by far.
Next morning.
Man, Haven really parties at this festival, huh?
The Spring Fest is pretty cool, but I should... Good luck with that sign. Couldn't have said it better myself.
No, Mom, it's not an emergency. Trust
Typhon is not normal. I made a mistake coming here.
Get out while you can, dude.
Typhon is really... I don't know.
Tomorrow,
gotta pull my shit together for this grand opening. These people won't be so gracious forever.
We might. Free food goes a long way in Haven.
Come introduce yourself.
I'll take a coupon.
No coupons, my dear. Just tell me your name and I'll remember it.
All right, Alex Chen.
Alex Chen? Didn't we speak already tonight?
Nope.
Stupid. So stupid. Print some coupons, they said. It's a small town. I'll remember, I said. Oh, hubris.
You know, you could try posting on my block. Whoever comments gets the deal.
Oh. Well, that's a good idea.
Best of luck. Nice. May the best small town diner win.
Are you serious right now? A boot? A fucking boot?
One, two, three. I control me. One, two. Fuck! I don't control shit!
Oof, sorry, man. We've all been there.
Hey! Boot! Fuck you! You think you're making the world a better place? Think you're doing a service for the citizens? You're just a goddamn
tool. Too bad I can't unlock doors with my emotions.
You're caught in the machine, you metal fuck!
Whoa, dude.
I don't want to be late for this surprise. Time to head up to the rooftop. There's still a decent crowd milling around tonight. Even Steph's signs are badass.
For you.
Good surprise or bad surprise?
I started a farm.
Didn't expect that him playing my favorite game would be a turn on, but here we are. The nurse, she's adorable.
I'll be real with you right now.
Wait, is someone standing out past the Bridge of Flowers? Pretty late for a bus ride. I don't get it.
We'll just have to wait. That's all.
Maybe Riley could use some company right now. Hey, Riley.
Oh. Hey. What are you doing here?
Just taking a walk. I needed a breather from all that socializing.
I get that. I was supposed to leave on the bus tonight. So many hopes and dreams all poured into one fucking bus ride. But it's okay. Nana needs me now. She was there for me before, and now it's my turn. And I don't have to do it solo. Mac is still helping around the shop, even with us broken up.
Eleanor is so lucky to have you.
Thanks, Alex.
Hang in there, okay?
I will. You're awesome for coming out here. Nana, no, hey, don't put that sticker up.
And why not? Aren't I allowed to be proud of...
Anna, I'm not going, remember? I'm staying here, with you.
Right. Yes, of course. I... Riley... I'm sorry.
Nothing to be sorry about. We'll scrape it off tomorrow.
The LARP was a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was.
Damn it. I'm head over heels for this dork. What do I do?
That's a rough place to be.
God, I still like her so much. What do I do?
Wait, they're both into each other? Come on, people.
Hey, I just wanted to say, you two make a really cute couple.
Oh! Thanks, Alex. That's really sweet.
That idea doesn't bother you?
Us being a couple?
Yeah.
I kind of like it.
Holy shit. Okay, so does this mean... Do you want to,
go out sometime? Yes.
But just the two of us?
Yes. An actual date. Devoid of pottery or third wheels.
Okay. Okay, great.
Alex Chen out here, covering Cupid's lazy ass.
Oh my god. My heart's still pounding.
Can confirm.
Holy shit. Is this really happening?
I accept cash and checks.
There's still a decent crowd milling around tonight. Mandatory night off? I'll take it. Ugh. Not tonight. It was so fun watching Jed play the villain. What a good sport. Jed bought this as a treat for the regulars. And himself, I'm guessing. Well played, kitchen staff. Odds are pretty good. I'm grabbing a cup later tonight. What about acute emotional kleptomania? Eleanor is like a mafia boss. Except instead of crime, she spreads flowers.
It's not the same without you, Tabitha. Never was, never will be.
Tabitha, sounds like Ducky's got a story to tell. Hey, Ducky, who's Tabitha?
Do you want to talk about her?
You know, Alex, on this particular matter, I don't have much to say.
Okay. There's gotta be more I can do for Ducky. Okay. Tell me what I need to know to help him.
You know, I carved that myself. Oh, hi, I'm Reginald McAllister III. My friends call me Ducky.
Tabitha Baker. Call me Tabs.
Drink it. Look at the bottom.
What? What are you... Oh, Ducky, it's beautiful.
Tabitha Baker, will you marry me?
Happy anniversary, love. Here's to another 30 years.
And another 30 festivals, if we can make it.
Ducky, you're gonna outlast this whole damn town.
I know that song. Poor Ducky. Maybe there's something I can do.
Happy anniversary, love. Here's to another 30 years.
And another 30 festivals, if we can make it.
Ducky, you're gonna outlast this whole damn town.
It's a tough night for you. Isn't it? The Spring Fest?
That's right.
Did you actually carve that wooden bear?
Brana? Sure did. That was a long time ago.
The Spring Festival must have been important to you two.
Indeed. We were married at the festival. We both loved it so much.
Give me one sec.
How did you...
They're playing your song. Let's dance.
Some dreams passing by, love seemed like that before.
I see clearly, so we don't need any charm. No tarot cards, no dice, no crystal set in eyes. Starlight in the night, shining down upon our love as it takes flight. Just seems that with some passing luck, we might find all that we've had before, and some more. Now those cobwebs of rainbows, stars of the sky are real.
You know what reminds me most of her right now? It's not the song or the festival. It's that you took the time to care about a sad old man for no other reason than to make the world a little less troublesome. That was Tabs. Thank you, Alex. I think I'm a little more inclined to join the others outside.
You're very welcome. Enjoy the festival.
Ta-da! It's a tree.
For me? I've never been given a tree before.
My mom used to get insomnia when I was a kid. She'd drive over here to the lantern, 3 in the morning, work in the garden. Sometimes she'd take me with her. It's always been a special place for me. I hope it can be for you too.
I should have been taking better care of it.
Come on. You've had other stuff to worry about, like totally killing that set. You're such a rock star.
Thanks for everything. I had fun.
So did the audience. You know they're going to make you do it again next year, right? You good?
Yeah, fine. Guess I've just been too wrapped up to think about what the future looks like.
Okay. So let's think about it. Alex's future in Haven Springs.
The major motion picture.
The Ride.
On ice.
Close your eyes. It's morning. Chilly. You can see your breath. You're walking down Main Street on the way to work. Where?
The lantern.
Okay. Kind of a safe choice, but I get it. So after work. Sun's still up for another couple hours. It's warm now. You're carrying your jacket under your arm. What's the plan?
Maybe I'm all outdoorsy now. A real Colorado girl. Up in the mountains with one of those little stabby sticks.
Trekking pole? Not as good for stabbing as you'd think. Hey, would you look at that? Who's that coming down the trail?
Who?
Only the coolest person in Haven Springs. He walks up to you in an extremely cool way. His plaid jacket swaying in the breeze.
Dork.
Yeah. I'm not trying to get you to plan out your whole life, but if you decide you wanted to put down roots, Haven Springs will always make space for you.
Was that a gardening pun?
No. Maybe. I really care about you, Alex. A lot. You're the most amazing person I've ever met.
Dummy, kiss her. Kiss her.
I really want to kiss you right now.
I know.
Festivities? I'll get you a phone cake.
Maybe you could save me one.
Yeah, of course. I'll see you down there.
Hey, Gabe. Can I tell you something? I think I solved it. Why you died. Who's responsible. Isn't that crazy? I'm out of threads to pull. Which is terrifying. Because on the other side of all this, after Typhon, after you, there's just normal life. Kind of counting on you to show me how to do that. But I think I can figure it out. I just wish you were here to see it. Also, I kissed Ryan. So, that happened.
Alex.
Do you have the USB drive?
I do. It's all here. Gabe's call, their secret plan, the cover-up.
You need to come with me to the station. Alex? Don't make this hard. Probably isn't how you pictured your first spring festival, huh?
Not exactly.
Coffee?
Coffee would be great. Thanks.
I don't know why I offered. We're actually out.
Pike, why am I here?
The long and short of it is, Diane is charging you with stealing her USB drive.
What the hell are you talking about?
Did you steal this USB drive or not?
At least tell me you looked at it.
I can't. Sorry.
What do you mean? Why not?
Well, one, I would need a warrant. And two, the case is closed. The order came down today. I did what I could, but, you know, the evidence just wasn't there. Sorry, Alex.
The order came down today from who?
High up. Boss's boss's boss. It's not my job to know.
Look, what happened to my brother wasn't an accident. It was criminal. The files on that drive prove it.
That could be true. Let's say it is. The issue is, you stole Typhon's property. I can't work with that.
Okay, I get the point. I'm sorry I stole the drive, but...
Apologizing isn't enough. Alex, you're not thinking about this clearly.
Seems pretty clear to me.
Diane wants to charge you with computer fraud. That's a federal crime, Alex. 5 to 10, easy.
You know what? Fuck Diane. This isn't justice. This is a joke.
It's not that bad. Hey, I talked to her, and despite how angry she is at everything you did, she's willing to let it go. If you agree to drop everything, Typhon won't press any charges.
She's only offering that deal because she knows I have her. She's guilty, Pike.
Even if you're right, your only evidence is inadmissible. I think you should do it.
Fuck that. I'm not signing anything.
Alex.
No. Typhon buried something in the mountains. Something so massive, they ignored Gabe's call and set off the blast just to cover it up. Don't you want to know what it is?
What do you mean, cover it up?
Another blast, unannounced, set off at the exact same time at the old mining site. And all of it happened just a few weeks before inspections were set to begin. Come on, Pike. It's all right here.
Like I said, it doesn't matter. Alex, please, just sign the form, and we can both go back to the party.
No.
Alex, this is not an offer that you can choose.
I said no.
No is not an option.
What are you so scared of?
See for yourself.
Shit. What could be in that envelope?
Alex, please. I don't want you to get hurt.
Then help me, damn it. Is this a threat?
What did you expect? Huh? The Typhon, a global organization with billions in revenue, an army of lawyers, and who knows how many politicians in their pockets would just throw up their hands and say, "You got us."
I thought I could get justice for Gabe.
Yeah. Well, Typhon has their own idea of justice.
Shit.
Believe me, I want nothing more than to make these fuckers pay. I've learned the hard way that it's not possible. They're too big. Too connected, too ruthless. You can hate me if you want. Call me a coward. But I don't want to lose you like we lost Gabe.
Pike is terrified of Typhon. I bet if I took his fear away. But it's not just about me. Steph and Ryan are in danger too. Fuck. I want to hurt Typhon so bad. But can I really put their lives at risk along with mine?
Risk your life over this? Gabe, Mac, Alex, who's next? Fuck. 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 Just keep your head down, Billy. You're just a shitheel. Typhon's major league. Typhon doesn't lose. Typhon disappears, people. Let them get killed. Not you.
I know you're afraid. I am too. I know you think that Typhon is too big, too
invincible. But they're not. I will bring them down. I just need your help. If not for me, then for Gabe. Please.
Fuck.
I'll think about it.
Thank you.
Get the hell out of here.
Really?
Alex. Be careful.
Those pictures. How long have they been watching us? And what will they do if... I have no idea what to do next. Maybe talking to Jed will help me feel better. First, I need to get out of this dress. I'll treasure it too, Ryan. Enjoy that ice cream. I'm glad Ducky had a nice night. He deserves it. Maybe I should start charging for my services. This isn't over, Gabe. I promise. Ducky. Hope he's doing okay. Riley probably can't help me hack Typhon. Yep. The tables seem to have turned, all right. Looks like I'm on my own now. I don't want to drag Ryan and Stefan any deeper. I think I'm all played out for tonight. Maybe I'll just bike out to the mine, dig up some answers myself. That must be Ryan's. I guess the night wasn't all bad. Might as well go talk to Jed now.
feels like the LARP was 100 years ago. Hey, Jed.
There she is. Have a seat. Seat. Something tells me you've had a more exciting spring festival than you planned for.
You saw Pike arrest me.
And let you go, apparently. Then there's that business with Ryan and Steph earlier today. I wasn't sure why it took all three of you to work out Diane's lunch order. I know you're used to looking out for yourself. Gabe was like that. But Haven's a community. We help each other. I want to help you. But first, you have to let me know what's going on.
Fuck it. What have I got to lose? Typhon killed Gabe. I have proof.
What proof?
I stole it from Diane. Emails and documents proving there was a second explosion the night Gabe died. To cover something up, Jed. Some secret they buried. I don't know what it is. I don't even know what to do next. But I'm not giving up. Not ever.
I know what they're hiding.
Please, Jed. What's the truth? What are they afraid of?
Typhon's the devil that runs this town. I've been carrying their secrets for far too long. I know what they buried in the mountains.
Tell me.
I'll do one better. I'll show you. There, up ahead.
Where are we?
Middle of nowhere. About 2 clicks that way is the mining site where you search for Ethan. 5 clicks that way is town.
What is this thing?
Ventilation shaft. They're scattered everywhere. Over the years, mines grow into mines, creating a labyrinth under Haven. What you're searching for is down below.
Jed, why are you sad?
Sorry, kid.
Jed, what are you doing?
I tried to talk you out of it. Scare you off. I was sure those pictures of Ryan and Steph would do the trick. But you were relentless. Won't leave damn well enough alone.
You don't have to do this.
I do. 12 years ago, I made a mistake. The kind of thing that you can't undo. But Typhon made me a deal. A way to save my town. Give my boy a normal life. I never wanted Gabe to get hurt.
Go to hell.
Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings.
Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a sweet boy. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
You're wrong. I don't belong in here.
If that were true, Alex, you'd know you were talking to an empty chair.
What the fuck?
Babe.
my guitar. Knock, knock. Is that what I look like? Really? These don't belong to Dr. Lin. A tuning peg. How did I even get back here? Dr. Lin always recorded our... records our sessions. Guess that's me. Case number 53322. Thrown down a... what? Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure. Huh. Thank you.
Oh!
Alex.
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Oh, Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me. We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. It scared me to death. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school.
Gabe? Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom, are you okay?
Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be...
She knew. Even then, she knew. It was always too hot in this room. How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating vending machine dinners. There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry. Mom. Every time I saw her, I worried it would be the last. Hi, Mom.
can.
Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay.
Wait. Did I miss something? There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry. She's just on the other side.
Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? No tears, my strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you. You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex? Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Ha ha ha.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both. This is going to suck so bad. Play your part. You know that's not how it went down, right?
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did, Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school. Mom and Dad had this TV before they had either of us. I tried so hard to keep my promise to her. Dad's laundry. I always set it here when it was done so he could find it. At least I managed to hold on to you, Shushu. Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me. The killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right. Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept, "Thanks for trying, lucky cat." My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice. I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. I can't believe they were ever this happy. Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about. We never really touched these after Mom died. She was 2 cups water for 1 cup rice. Set timer for 30 minutes. Do your history homework. Serve. Almost empty. Almost always.
Hey, Gabe. I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there, okay?
Mom's old sewing kit. Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it gonna take to get you to stop defending him?
If your mother could see you now.
I don't want to hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit!
Dad.
Damn it. Alex!
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad! Dad, it's okay. Really, I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Dad?
someone will come. That woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad.
I'm sorry.
No. Dad!
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You are 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Play my part. I used to write one every day. Stupid.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I guess I missed a few days. How you holding up, Shu?
Can't believe how long you've had that thing.
That thing was my only friend. We weren't allowed to bring glass into the dorms, so we had to drink from this thing.
I can't. Pretty sure it's locked.
Must be Epcot. They put me on so many meds.
Did any of them ever work?
Some of them helped. A little. None of them fixed me.
In their defense,
they used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Well, maybe they were trying to keep you safe.
Guess so. Whatever the reason, the end result was prison bars. They used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Maybe they were trying to keep you safe.
Guess so. Whatever the reason, they should have stenciled the same thing on all of us.
you really feel like you were their property?
We didn't belong to anyone else, did we? I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
That's bullshit! I don't need it in the fucking rec room! I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms!
Alex, that's enough! Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
Everyone's feelings were so loud. I just needed something to distract me.
Everyone had one good outfit. We wore them to meet the parents.
Did it help?
Kinda think you already know the answer to that question.
If I want to get out of here, I've got to play my part. Remember the kid who put this here? Sadie? Sally. Something with an S?
You were friends at first, right?
Way at first. Then I freaked out on her and she was done with me. Just like everyone else. Thank you.
I guess I've got to take a seat. Face the music.
Pretty sure it's locked.
Must be after curfew. We're not going anywhere.
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
I wonder why she's never found a home before. She's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something
off.
Broken. Wrong.
With her.
Sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. People leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.
A way out of here. No more ladder. Not that I'd be much good at climbing. Mines growing into mines, just like Jed said. I'm gonna choose not to read anything into this. I could almost laugh if it wouldn't hurt so much. How long has this stuff been down here? No.
I can do this. I can do this. Okay, that's something. That aura is the only lead I've got.
All right, boys, getting close.
Helldivers for life, huh, Jed?
Dig so deep, we see where the devil sleeps.
Goddamn right.
This is it. This is what Typhon tried to bury.
A lot of runoff moisture in this soil. Jed, we gotta call it. This dig is fucked.
Nothing's fucked.
Jed, we got no pumps running. No.
My teams have never quit a dig this deep before. We finish the job. Steady goes. Steady.
Fuck was... Move! Come on! Clear the tunnel! Who's on radio?
Jed!
Fuck!
Jed! Jed!
Oh my god.
We gotta move! Now!
There's still men back there! They'll drown!
Yeah, and so will we if we don't get the fuck out! Make the call, Jed!
God damn it! God damn it! Everyone, let's go! Now!
Smells like fireworks. Must be where Typhon blew the charges.
Jed! Come back! Jed, you son of a bitch! Jed, you gotta stop, man. Jed! Fuck you, Jed! Come back!
It's over, Chen. He's not coming back.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
And during my time here, I've come to realize what makes Haven so special. It's a flower shop run by multiple generations. A bar owner who greets every customer by name. It's a spring festival tradition going back 100 years. History, loyalty, pride. These values which define Haven are the same values that Typhon was built on. And that is why our partnership has been so successful. It's been my privilege to renew Typhon's commitment to Haven. We believe in this community, and we're tremendously excited for its future.
Thank you, Diane. I think I speak for all of us when I say we're eager to make this official. So, time to vote, folks. And then lunch.
God, I'm fine. You are not fine. We have to get you to a doctor.
What happened to you?
I found out something you need to hear. I'm sorry.
What?
Alex, you're hurt.
Do you need help? We can call an ambulance.
Typhon's been lying to all of you. And so has Jed Lucan.
Alex, what's going on?
Fuck you.
What the hell happened?
I was down in the mine last night. I saw what Typhon's been hiding for 12 years. Jed Lucan isn't a hero. That whole story is a lie. Jed caused the accident. And then he abandoned 7 of his men. He let them drown to save himself. There were pictures of me and Gabe down there in the dirt. Because one of those miners was my father. Typhon wanted to keep this covered up in case it jeopardized the vote. All they care about is making more money. They'll do whatever it takes to push this expansion through.
so they decided to bury the evidence. And nothing was going to stop that blast. Not even the fact that there were four people up in the mountains. That's how Gabe was killed. Jed knew all along. He covered up the truth about the past, about Gabe. And when I found out, as you can see, he tried to kill me too. Why aren't any of you saying anything?
We don't want to embarrass you, Alex.
I wasn't asking you.
The things you've said obligate me to at least address them. These accusations are, well, they're insane. And trying to go into the mine was obviously a very dangerous, very illegal thing to do. But we all sympathize with your situation. You've been through so much. Your brother was your only family, wasn't he? I can only imagine how much you want an explanation for his loss. Something to give you comfort and make your life seem less unfair.
Why don't you just tell the truth? You've been planning your exit from Typhon anyway.
What?
You never signed up for threats or attempted murder. You hate this. Now's your chance to stop.
Dad? Do you have any idea what Alex is talking about?
No. I don't. I've tried to be there for Alex since Gabe died. I thought, I don't know, I hoped I could be something of a father figure to her. All I can guess is, sometimes when we're hurting, the people we lash out at are the ones who were trying to help.
You tried to kill me. How can you stand there and say these things?
Alex.
You're a monster. Please. I know this is hard to accept. You all trust him. I did too. But I'm telling the truth.
I believe you. Of course I do.
I would like to speak. This young lady came to Haven as a stranger. But over the last few weeks, she's become one of us. Now, her story certainly seems unlikely, if not impossible. But she deserves at least an investigation of her claims. We ought to take her seriously.
Ducky, you're being unhelpful. Alex, sweetheart. You know our mind can play tricks on us. None of it is your fault. So hard to admit you need help. But it's always better in the end. We're all worried about you. Let us help you.
Charlotte.
No. Leave me alone. I don't want any more of this.
They killed Gabe.
What are you trying to do?
take down Typhon? That won't bring him back. All I know is everything falls to shit when you're involved. There's something wrong with you, Alex. And now there's something wrong with me. I can't help you. I'm sorry.
Don't worry, Alex. I got this.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I have a USB stick full of recordings.
Yes, we went through this yesterday. Your superiors closed the case. None of us have time for conspiracies.
Yeah. You're trying to weasel your way out of things again, huh? I know your game. I know.
Don't test me, Jason.
You know what? I'm not scared of you anymore. And not of you. Not Typhon.
All right, that's enough.
Deputy Pike, do you have some kind of personal issue with me?
Like hell I do.
Jason. Well, given that your judgment in this matter is emotionally compromised, you should probably remove yourself from...
Oh, cut the crap. If you think you could shut me up...
Jason, I think you better cool it. I would like to speak again.
It concerns me that a voting member of this council...
I'm really sorry.
...admitted to a personal bias that...
This is a load of bullshit.
Are you?
I don't believe
this. Getting ridiculous.
We're all getting ahead of ourselves. What's the important...
Why are you doing this?
I'm not your lapdog anymore.
Deputy Pike, I am not what? Responsible for any frustrations you feel...
My dad is not a murderer. Were you afraid we couldn't get Typhon? Is that why you need someone else to blame? I thought we were in this together. For Gabe. And me. I thought you cared about me.
Ryan.
No. I'm not gonna let you do that to me anymore.
Ryan, what the hell? I know he's your dad, but look at her. Why would she lie about this?
It's going too far.
Alex almost died.
It's not true.
Fuck you, Ryan! After everything? Seriously, fuck you! Stop.
I know why you tried to kill me. It's not what you tell yourself. That you thought it was best for Haven. This was never about Haven at all, was it? This was about you. I know it's easier not having to think about the men you buried. You want to look away and pretend the people you hurt aren't people. But I won't let you. My father worked for you. His name was John. The world never gave a shit about him. He was always struggling just to get by. He still hoped one day things would be better. But you killed him. And then Gabe, my big brother. He was building a family here, doing it his own way, figuring it out as he went along. He was so nervous about it, and so excited. And he brought me here to be part of that family. But he died. Because of you. And then there's me. For so many years, I just wanted to survive. To get through. Haven changed me.
I started to think about the future. I want to help people. Because it's something I'm good at. Knowing I'm good at something feels fucking great. And you tried to murder me. You would have ended my life just so you wouldn't have to face the truth. You've forgotten it, haven't you? You've plastered over it with another story. You tell yourself you're a hero, a strong leader. Sometimes that means making hard choices, decisions that could lead to people dying. Few men could handle that. Haven's lucky to have you. But that's the lie. If you scrape it away, what do we see? Eleven years ago, you led a group of men to their deaths. And then you gave your soul to Typhon. You let them tell you how awful it would be for your wife and son to find out. You let them tell you that Haven was more important than the men who died. When it really mattered who you were and what you stood for, you let Typhon decide for you. I can feel you trying to pull away. Don't. The truth hurts. Sometimes it's so awful you think you're gonna break. But when you come out the other side, and you're whole and free and still alive, then you'll finally know how strong you really are. See the truth about you. You hate yourself. You hate what you did in the past. You hate what you've done to keep it secret. And the more you deny that hatred, the worse it grows. I know who you are. I've seen the worst parts of you. And I forgive you.
Still coming in on the Typhon mining scandal that has rocked the western slope town of Haven Springs, where a council meeting was the scene for shocking revelations. Local bar owner and council president Jed Lucan admitted in a tearful confession to covering up the deaths of seven Typhon employees as their manager 12 years ago. A recent cover-up, which involved a clandestine and unpermitted explosion to thwart inspections, caused the death of Haven local Gabe Chen last month. Mr. Lucan is currently in police custody, awaiting arraignment. We will have plenty more about this developing story, including the resignation of Typhon CEO, the market impact, and what it all means for your drive time commute, coming right.
Yeah, the silence is worse. I need to get some air. Do I need a Charlotte Harmon portrait? I kind of think I need a Charlotte Harmon portrait. I've got some continued support for you. The phrase recent events is doing some work in this post. It never ends. I'm so sorry I worried you all. I bet Steph wishes she could reword that, but it's pretty funny. After summoning all my... strength and willpower, I'm now ready
to move from the bed to the rooftop. Maybe Dad deserved everything he got, but I'm still glad we were there with him in his last moments. I love this guitar, but if it starts asking me riddles again, I'm throwing it out the window. I've been playing a lot the last 2 days, trying to think things through. But I realize it's actually the opposite. When I'm playing is the only time I get to not think. Not think about Jed, or Gabe, or Haven, and wanting to move on from the pain, but not knowing how. Most of all, what I don't think about is me, because I've never been good at that. And suddenly, it's the only question that's left. So, I just keep playing. I haven't spoken to Ryan since the vote. What am I even supposed to say to him? Must be rare that a local paper gets to break out the really big headline.
You ever swing a pick before, Mr.
Chen? John, and no. But I'm a hard worker, and I learn fast, and I don't mind long hours.
You don't have somebody waiting on you at home?
No, sir.
Well, John, guess you're a hell diver now.
Chad must have thought he was seeing a ghost the first time Gabe walked in. Nothing like being called delusional by someone you trusted. That one really hurt. I'm glad he held on to it, for whatever it's worth. I'll never understand exactly what happened to me down there, but I'll always be grateful.
I know now that my inaction in the face of injustice was itself a terrible wrong. And I know that I will never be able to undo the tremendous pain and loss I caused. I do not ask for forgiveness. The only person who could give that to me is gone. Thank you.
There are no victims. Was Charlotte's response all my fault? Or would she have turned on me no matter what? I felt very close to Ducky after our dance. I guess he felt the same way. They say I was powered by adrenaline that whole morning. Now, I'm mostly powered by extra strength Advil. And these. The LARP was 2 days ago? That doesn't seem possible. Maybe I do deserve some dollar sign justice, but I'd much rather be able to move on with my life. I want to go outside without seeing anyone. That's why God created rooftops.
so sorry.
I know.
What you said? The truth about my dad? I couldn't accept it. Maybe I wasn't strong enough. After everything he did, you still forgave him. I didn't know it was possible to be that strong. And it gives me hope that maybe one day I can be that strong too.
Thank you, Ryan. That means a lot.
What about us? Do you think you could ever forgive me what I did?
I already do. You faced something horrible, and for a moment, you turned away.
I should have known. Maybe deep down I did, but I just couldn't accept it.
But it's out now. And as horrible as it is, we don't have to face it alone. We have each other.
So, what's next for Alex Chen? I guess I'm asking because I'm in. I mean, whether it's here or anywhere else, if you want me, I'm there.
You would really leave Haven?
Sure. What's left for me here anyway? Unless you were staying.
I'm not used to getting to decide what I want. I guess I'd better think about it.
I guess so. You know where to find me.
All right, just tell me.
What?
My future. What to do? The night of the Spring Fest, Ryan made a strong case for why I should stay in Haven. The idea of making this place my home. It seemed nice. Of course, that was before all this shit went down. Come on, you're the know-it-all. So tell me.
Actually, I do know what you should do. You should stay in Haven.
You really think so?
Of course. You finally have a home. A job? People who actually like you? Why would you give that up?
That's true.
Then again, maybe leaving would be better.
What?
You're young, you suddenly have a little money, friends. And don't you think it's time to give this music thing a real shot? No, you should definitely leave.
Oh, fuck off. Stop it, Gabe. I don't need the mysterious spirit bullshit right now. I just need my big brother.
I'm sorry.
I know.
But here's something. It's 3 hours from now. A bus pulls away. You're not on it. Ryan approves. Life goes on. You go back to work. You settle into a routine. And one day, with almost no warning, Steph up and bolts town. It hurts. But she does offer you a going away present. Her job. You take it. All those years of being a music snob finally pay off. And little by little, time does its thing. The apartment starts to feel less like a museum and more like a home. Thoughts of Jed, of Typhon, even of me, begin to fade into the background. Rooftop is your stage. You perform every week to a small but adoring group of fans. Maybe while you play, you wonder what could have been. Performing for more people in more cities, sharing your music with the world. Or maybe you never think about that much at all. You don't know exactly when it happens, but one day you look around and find that you have transformed this place just as much as it has transformed you. And the most extraordinary thing of all is just how normal it feels. You don't question it. You don't doubt it. Or wonder what might have been. It's your life. The life you fought so hard to have. And for the first time in a long time, you just live.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
You really think I'll transform Haven?
Of course. You already have. With your gift, your music, just by being you. But Alex, that doesn't mean you have to stay. You have the potential to do that anywhere you go.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't have any other home.
That is true. But you didn't have any home before coming here. And look what happened. The truth is, there's no telling what that version of your future might be. The only promise is the adventure. So, what do you think?
I know what I want.
long time, I would sit alone and think that I'm better off all by myself, even if I sink. But you found me, and you helped me see the light, the dim fluorescent flicker in a dark, defeated night. I've had my fair share of losing, and I've hung on by a thread within meaning, and the memories gained friends and wrote some melodies in the darkness. I just couldn't look ahead. I was blinded by my own self-doubt and forgot what I was all about. Move forward and try to let yourself in. It's not a bad thing to be brave. March on a path that you will be.
Thank you.